So this joint work with PhD student Stian Fauskanger. So on this slide you see block ciphers. This is plain text, this is the first round of block ciphers. Those are internal rounds, this is last round. And we look at some bits which is output of the first round. Those bits are input to the last round. And we find a joint distribution of these two vectors. These are vectors, not one bit. And this distribution actually depends on all these key bits. This is round keys. We are able to find some approximation to this distribution. And we want to use this distribution in kind linear cryptanalysis. So if the size of this vector is large, or the size of this vector is large, so observation on the x, y depends on so many key bits from the first round key and the last round key. So conventional linear cryptanalysis, multivariate linear cryptanalysis is not efficient. This cryptanalysis uses logarithmic likelihood ratio statistic. In this case, observation and depends on so many key bits. Distribution itself depends on some key bits, so that statistic itself depends on so many key bits. And to use this statistic, you need the 2-power size of the key bits computation. This is too expensive. So instead, we propose to use a number of projections. We know distribution of this vector, so we can compute distribution of this vector. This are projections of this vector. We use only linear projections. This is more, more easy to use. And each projection may depend on low number of key bits. And that is a quite important fact. So we are able to construct a vector of logarithmic likelihood ratios for each projection. And we know distribution of this vector asymptotically. If value of key is correct, this a priori distribution, this vector distributed as a multivariate normal vector with parameters which are easy to compute. And otherwise, if the value of this key bits is not correct, it's distributed in this way, where n is the number of variable plaintext. It's supposed to be big. Now we need to distinguish between two normal distributions. And we use LLR statistic. Fortunately, this LLR statistic is a linear combination of LLR statistic for projections with some weights which are computed explicitly. And we know distribution of the statistic. It distributed this way is one-variate normal distribution if the value is correct. And if the value is not correct, it's distributed this way. And we use this fact in cryptanalysis of block cipher. So we can reconstruct the number of values of these key bits from the values of key bits which affect the projection. And this value which we want to reconstruct should satisfy this condition where S is the statistic we constructed. This is some threshold. And we devise an algorithm by working over a search tree. Because we know distribution of this statistic, we can compute success probability as the number of key candidates in the end to be brute forced. We implemented this attack against full DES. We used 28 10-bit projections. And we computed success probability. We took it 85% as in Matsuis. And the number of key candidates, 56 bit candidates to brute force was 2^41.8. The number of plain text is 2^41.8. It may be compared with Matsui's success probability 85%. And the number of key candidate to brute force is 2^43. And the number of plain text is 2^43. You see that it's a little bit better. And another advantage of our method is we can compute success probability theoretically. This is usually a difficult problem for such kind of attacks. This is a basic variant of our method, and we have room for improvements, and the work is still in progress. Thank you very much.